The next problem of this topic, part 2, is delta H for the reaction. Reaction is given and different states are noted here. And the delta H value is given at 25 degrees Celsius and calculate delta U for the reaction. R is given, 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole. Now, what is your job? First, write down all the data in a sequence. Then observe the unit. All units should be in SI or the ratio should be same. Here, the delta H in kilojoule, R in joule. So, convert this joule into kilojoule means multiply by 10 raised to power minus 3 kilojoule. And temperature is in degree Celsius, we should be in Kelvin. So, at plus 273, it is equal to 298. Then, the formula used for the enthalpy change. Here, enthalpy change formula is noted and all the values are given. Delta U is to be calculated. Here you have to calculate delta U and all this delta H is given, R is given, temperature is given and delta L, number of moles of gaseous product minus reactant is not given, which you have to calculate. This is called as subcalculations. So delta Ng is not given. What is delta Ng? It is the number of moles of gaseous product minus gaseous reactant. Here gaseous product C2H6 hydrogen and this is solid. So this should not be used for the calculation of number of moles. Delta Ng you have to calculate. So one here, one molecule and here three. Therefore 1 minus 3 equal to minus 2 mole. Now put up all the values with unit. So final calculation, final answer comes up with unit. Write down all the units and cancel the common term. Moles cancel with per mole. Kelvin per Kelvin cancel with Kelvin. Now only kilojoule remains. And put up the values. After putting values, the simplification should be done. Here delta U minus 4.96 goes here, so minus converted to plus and final answer comes out to be like this. The next problem is, in a particular reaction 2 kilojoule of heat is released by the system and 6 kilojoule of work is done on the system. Determine delta H and delta U. You come to know that this problem is based on first law of thermodynamics. First of all, write down the all values. Q equal to minus 2 kilojoule, W equal to plus 6 kilojoule because on the system. Work done on the system, therefore we are writing plus 6. If by the system, then minus 6. Here on the system, therefore plus 6. Calculate delta U and delta H. First law of thermodynamics is given here. Simple formula. Put up all the values and calculate. It comes out delta U plus 4 kilojoule. Now QP equal to delta H. In theory, we learned this topic. And as the delta H and QP is identical, write down the delta H value. Here, QP value means delta H means minus 2. And delta H equal to minus 2 kilojoule. The next problem is, calculate work done in oxidation of 4 moles of SO2 at 25 degrees Celsius. What you have to calculate? Work done means W is to be calculated for 4 moles. Observe the data given. The data given for 2 moles of SO2. These are the 2 moles. So first of all, you have to write the reaction for 4 moles. And you have to state whether the work done on the system or by the system. You have to mention the on the system or by the system by observing the sign and the value. So the solution is like this for oxidation of 4 moles. Here 2 moles reaction is given and we want for 4 moles. Therefore double the coefficient. Here instead of 2, 4. Here instead of 1 O2 molecule, 2. And SO3 is 2. Therefore here 4. Means this is the reaction. Now calculate delta Ng. This calculation is for work done in a chemical reaction. And in theory, we discuss this part very clearly and different formulae are given by me and I hope you must learn all that formulae. So use the formulae W equal to minus delta Ng RT. How delta Ng is calculated? The number of moles of gaseous product, only gaseous product minus the number of moles of gaseous reactant. So how many moles are here? Here 4 moles. Therefore I got 4. Then here 2 moles and here 4 moles. Means 4 plus 2, 6. These are gas. First of all, you have to mention, you have to focus on that point, only gaseous product and gaseous reactant are to be considered. Therefore, 4 minus 6 equal to minus 2 mole. R and T is given. T is given in degree Celsius, convert into the Kelvin. Now, put up all the values. Here, with unit, minus 2 mole, 8.313, like this. Now, cancel the common term. Here, mole with per mole, per Kelvin with Kelvin, cancel. Only joule remains. So, calculate with the log table. Write down here the calculations of log and add or minus whatever given here. And finally, take the anti-log. The final answer comes out to be 4955 joule. Converted into kilojoule by multiplying the factor 10 raised to power minus 3. Now, observe this sign. What is this sign? Here, sign is plus. Plus means work done on the system. Or another thing you can mention, here W is greater than 0, plus means greater than 0, minus means less than 0. So plus sign or W is greater than 0 means work done on the system. You have mentioned like this.